Hey guys, Bernardo Faria here, huge honor for me. Guys, today I'm making this video for the YouTuber NG87BJJ. He wrote a question on my YouTube asking like, hey Bernardo, I'm a new beginner in Jiu-Jitsu and I have hip problems. What advice do you have for a 32-year-old beginner who has hip problems? So I'm gonna extend his question here and I'm gonna give an advice here for a 32-year-old who has any type of injury, right? So guys, I truly believe that one of the beauties of Jiu-Jitsu is that you can always adapt anything you have when you are doing Jiu-Jitsu. I'm gonna give some examples here. For example, let's imagine that you play soccer or you play, soccer is the best example because you're gonna use your feet. So let's imagine that you play soccer and you have your feet injured very bad, maybe a chronic injury or something like that, that it's even hard for you to run. So it's gonna be almost impossible for you to play soccer, right? Because you can barely use your feet. So how are you gonna kick the ball? How are you gonna run? So I think one of the beauties of Jiu-Jitsu is that Jiu-Jitsu, you use your entire body anytime you're rolling, but you use your entire body, not like a soccer, for example, that is probably like you use 80% of your feet and 20% the rest of your body. No, Jiu-Jitsu, you probably use your hands just as much as you use your feet. You use your arm just as much as you use your knee. You use your neck just as much as you use your fingers. So what that means? That means that if you hurt one finger, if you hurt your hip, if you hurt your knee, you can always find a way to roll that you use less your knee and you use more your other leg, that you don't use your hip as much. Maybe you play more on top, you don't play that much on bar, and you can always find a way to adapt. I think that's like the beauty of Jiu-Jitsu. I don't know how many times in my career I have hurt like my right knee and I would train pretty much doing half roots to the other side to make sure I didn't need to use my knee. Or maybe I would hurt this finger and I would put tape and put these two fingers together, and now, or maybe I would hurt this shoulder and then I would use less this arm and play more with my left arm. So you can always adapt. I think that's the beauty of Jiu-Jitsu, that not too many sports are like that. For example, if you play tennis and you hurt this shoulder, you hurt this arm, you might need to stop and wait. So the advice that I would do here for you, if you're 32 years old, you just started Jiu-Jitsu and you have hip problems, every time you learn a new move, try to understand that move. And then try to select more the moves that it's not going to hurt your hip, right? So if you realize that playing on bar is very bad for you, try to play more on top, right? Try to build your game around playing on top. And even when you are on bar, try to figure out what's the type of guard that you can play. And of course, like, check it out with your doctor as well. See if you can actually do Jiu-Jitsu. Don't take Bernardo's advice and go deep in Jiu-Jitsu without checking your doctor. But that's kind of my advice. That's how I did in my career. Every time I would hurt something, I would always try to adapt my body to use less this part of my body and more the other parts of my body. And it has always worked for me. It was very, very, very few times in my life that I had to completely stop Jiu-Jitsu. And even those phases, for example, I remember one time I hurt my ribs very bad, very, very bad. So I had to stay out of Jiu-Jitsu for like almost 3 months. But I realized that after 1 month, I could start playing only on top. The problem was when I was on bottom. So I would literally make a deal with my training partner. If you get a sweep or anything like that, we stop and we start again. And I was just playing on top, 100% on top. If you would sweep me, or if anything happened, if you would take me down or anything like that, we would stop and we would start with Bernardo on top again. So we can always adapt, we can always find a way. Many times I would, if I got some bad injury, I would not row, I would just do the drills, maybe like in a higher speed and just watching the rows. So I would always figure out a way. And this is very different from the other sports, as you just saw. There are many sports that if you hurt that part of your body that you need, it's 80% of the game and you literally cannot just keep playing. You know, you gotta stop until you get better. So try to take advantage about that in jiu-jitsu, and at the same time be responsible, don't go crazy, and I hope that helps you.
Please help me out to grow my YouTube channel. Just click subscribe, and to watch more videos, just click under see more videos. I hope you enjoyed.
BJJFanatics.com. Use the promo code YouTubeFaria to get 10% off any instructional video. Improve your jiu-jitsu faster.